Hey everyone, this is Nick, and I'm coming to you with a viewer question from one of our videos on how to add a dot marker to your bar charts in PowerPoint and Excel. And this was a really great video that people asked. You can see we have a bar chart here and then the indicator dots on the bar. This would be great for showing a piece of data or a series of data against a target or a benchmark or a goal of some sort. And down here in comments, I'm gonna scroll down and you can see James comments from James Barnes. He asked, thank you, but do you know if there's a way to do this with a clustered bar chart? I'm trying to do that and running into issues with the secondary axis already being in use. This is a great question, James. And you can do this. You just have to do, you have to use a little bit different of a technique here. So on this initial chart, what we did is we added a series of data for the dots to a standard bar chart. And then we worked with the custom, the combo feature in the chart to create an XY scatter plot with these dots and put those on a secondary axis. We don't have to do that for the clustered bar chart option. And honestly, you could actually do what I'm about to do with this standard option too. The only thing is that it's not going to be as flexible, meaning you can't put individual data labels on the dots. But here we don't have that. And in most cases, you might not even need that. So we're going to go ahead and I'm going to show you how to do a chart something like this. Here or over in Excel, we have this clustered bar chart where we have the groups A through D. And then we have the series, the clustered series 1, 2, and 3. And then we have the indicator dots on each of those series. And you could make those indicator dots dynamic values. You could they could be individual values. They could be the same value down the column. But you can see how we have to set that up here. So it's basically, it's going to be one giant clustered bar chart with six different series. So you have your series 1, series 2, and series 3 here in these columns. And then I also have the indicator dot values, dot 1, dot 2, and dot 3. So this is how you're going to have to set up your data on the beginning. And I'm going to go ahead and copy this over, and we're going to put this into PowerPoint. Here's my PowerPoint slide. When you want to create a chart in PowerPoint, you can embed the create the chart right inside PowerPoint. Click on this little chart icon here, and then I'm going to go to the bar chart option, this 2D clustered bar. We're going to say OK. The data source pops up right here. This is just the canned, the stock values that they put into the charts in PowerPoint. We're going to go ahead and paste the values that I just copied. And now you can see we have, I'm going to go ahead and close out of the source range. Now you can see we have this really massive clustered bar chart with all of those six series for each of the groups there. I'm going to go ahead and delete the chart title here. We're not going to need that in this case. I'm going to move the legend up to the top. And I'm just going to go ahead and increase the height of the chart just a little bit so you can see it. Now what we're going to do, the first thing that I think of is let's work with the cluster, the actual cluster data. So the 1, the 2, and the 3 data here. So my 1 is blue right here, but I want this to be a lighter blue. So I'm going to go ahead and highlight these bars. We're going to go ahead and highlight them to this lower blue color. And then number 2, data series number 2 is this gray series here. So I'm going to highlight this. I'm going to make this a lighter orange. And then my series 3 data is this lighter blue, but I'm going to make this into a lighter green color. And you'll format these colors to however you think is best. All right, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to highlight the dot colors here to match. So dot 3 is this lighter green, or the series 3 is this, the cluster 3 is this lighter green. I want this to be a much darker green for the blue. So we're just going to go ahead and do that so you can see it. And then the dot value on this one is going to be dot number 2. That's going to be a darker orange. Let's fill that with a really deep orange. And then the dot 1 here, we're going to do a very dark blue. And I'm just doing this so that you can kind of get a sense of how I'm going to end up coloring the dots in the end. All right, so now what we do have to do is get onto that secondary axis, and we're going to change the chart type. So you can highlight the chart, go up to the chart design tab, and then click on change chart type up here. You can also right click the chart and click on change series chart type. The chart type menu will open up, and it's already set to combo down here. If yours is set to clustered bar, go down to combo, and you can see all of the series of data right here. And you can also put those series on a secondary axis. Now, this is what we did on that first video, but in this case, we're not going to change the chart types over here. All the chart types are going to stay clustered bar. And when you keep that consistent, the secondary axis, you can then put multiple series on that secondary axis if it's all in the same chart type. So I'm just going to put all of the dot series onto a secondary axis. So dot one, we're going to put on the secondary axis there. Dot two, we'll put on the secondary axis. And dot three, we will put on the secondary axis, and we'll say OK. Now you get this kind of wild chart here, kind of overlapping. Now we just have the three clusters right here, and the dot series are behind these. Now you can also see the secondary axis is set to 0 to 90%. We want to make sure that that's 100%. Now if you just click this axis and delete it, it will automatically go to whatever the primary axis is, so that's 0 to 100. But I'm going to go ahead and show you how to do that manually. So just click on that axis, go to the bar chart icon on the Format Axis menu, and then we're going to say this minimum is going to be 0. And this maximum is going to be 100, is going to be 100%, just one right there. And I'm actually just going to do this, update the primary axis manually as well, because if you ever wanted to update these data, we don't want that axis to be responsive. We want it to actually just be kind of hard-coded to 0 to 100%. So we're going to do that. And now I can go ahead and delete my secondary axis. Perfect. Now what we need to do is get the dots here. And what I want to do is I'm going to keep the series in the legend. You probably will want to create a custom legend for yourself at the end. And you might do that by just text boxes and shapes. But I'm going to show you a way that I learned from John Peltier on how to keep the axis colors consistent throughout a chart like this. So this is my dark green. This is my dot number three. What we're going to do is we're going to put error bars on this series here. So with that green series highlighted, we're going to go over to the little skittle right here and click on error bars. And then I'm going to go to the menu and click on percentage. And now you can see these error bars show up right here. Let's get rid of that. We're going to go ahead and work with these error bars to create our dots. Now this is a minus right here. We're going to click on minus and we're going to say no cap. And then under percentage, it's defaulted to 5%. We're going to do something very small, like 0.25. I think that will be really nice. And now you can see it's still selected, but there's a tiny little error bar right there. We're going to go to the paint bucket over here on the format error bar menu, and we're going to change it to that same deep green color. I'm going to go ahead and update the width to something really big. We're going to say 5 points here. And then under the begin arrow type, we're going to click on this little dot right here. That's how we create the start and end of an arrow bar and make it into a circle. Now you can see that little dot sort of appeared right there. And now all you need to do is set this series to no fill. Now I'm going to show you how to do this two ways. So the first, or two different things about this. So I can highlight the entire series right here, the entire green series, click on no fill. And now you can see those dots. But what you do also see is that the dot, the green square under the dot number three here on the legend has now disappeared because we set those bars to no fill. I'm going to go ahead and click undo. Here's a way that you can keep that green dot intact. So instead of highlighting the entire series of bars in one, we have to do this manually one by one. So I'm going to go ahead and double click on one bar to isolate it, click on no fill. And now I'm going to click on each individual dot, each individual green bar, and click on no fill. Now when I do that, you can see that that green shading on the legend right here has maintained its coloring, which is pretty cool. All right, now let's do this for the orange dot. So this dot number two, let's do the same thing. We're going to do error bars, percentage. Get rid of this. We're going to go over to that format menu, minus, no cap, percentage is going to be 0.25. We'll go back to the paint bucket. We're going to color this the same dark orange. We're going to set the width to number 5. And then we're going to set the begin arrow type to the circle. Now let's go ahead and manually click, double click one bar to isolate it. We're going to say no fill. And now if I double click this one and push F4, the F4 key, it should apply the same formatting that it just did to the previous. And it does that. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the bar to isolate, select F4, click on the bar to isolate, select F4. Beautiful. Now you have these indicator dots right there. Let's do the same thing one more time with the dot number one. We're going to put on percentage error bars. We will go over here. Select minus, no cap, percentage, 0.25. And I'm going to say 5 points for the width. We're going to update it to that blue, deep blue color. and then the begin arrow type will say to the circle. And it looks like it's maybe not quite as, maybe it's this blue. Yeah, that's what we wanted to do. And then we're gonna go ahead and isolate one bar, say no fill, click on the next bar to isolate it, push F4, next bar, F4, next bar, F4. Beautiful. Now you have a really nice clustered bar chart with those indicator dots. Now, if you wanted, if each of those indicator dot values maybe were different, we can change them. They don't have to be the same. So I'm going to right click the chart, click on edit data. The source, the data source pops up right here, and say dot number one, maybe for this group A, it was actually 30%. And then maybe this is 50%, and maybe this is 35%, and maybe this is 25%. But you can see that it then updates the chart manually there. And the same thing, you could say, maybe we wanted to edit the data for series one, we could do that here, and so on. So that's a pretty nice way that you could edit the data in these charts. Now, if you wanted the primary axis to be on the axis to be on the bottom, you could do this. If you wanted it to be on the top, we could actually just keep the secondary axis. So let's put the secondary axis back onto the chart. We'll click on the skittle right here, and then we'll say the secondary horizontal axis. There it is right there. And then maybe I could just delete my primary axis, and now I have my axis there at the top. That's one way that you can do that with one of these combination charts that has dual, that has two different axes on the lines there. Now, the one thing that you can't do is you can't make the dots in the legend, you can't make them circles. So what I would like to do is probably just do this manually. If I really wanted to have the legend and sort of maintain the legend, I could kind of work with how wide that legend is. I would probably do more direct labeling on each of these bars right there and get rid of my legend altogether. But if you wanted to have these dots as circles, you just insert a little tiny circle and make sure that it's colored into the same color. I'm gonna make it filled with that green and then say no outline. And then I'm just going to hold down shift and proportionally size this little tiny little circle there. And then you could just go ahead and put that on top of the dot. And we could go ahead and do that probably for the next one, push Control D to duplicate that circle. We will make this one a nice deep orange. Beautiful, Control D. And then make sure to just space this accordingly there. Perfect. And that's going to be the dot one color, that very deep blue. Wow, really nice. I think it looks like a pretty cool clustered bar chart with an indicator dot on top of each of those series. Now, this is going to be a pretty challenging chart type for most audiences to sort of decipher. So you're going to probably want to have some narrative text here. You may even want to be able to verbally describe how to read this chart for your audience. You might add some annotation text boxes here to help viewers understand what these mean. And maybe you'll work with the colors even more. So maybe only one of the clusters is one that I want to highlight. So maybe I would just kind of make the other clusters a muted shade of gray or something like that, and then add an action color onto the one that I wanted to do. So James, I hope this helps you do some of this, adding these indicator or benchmark dots to your clustered bar charts. It's a pretty cool technique, and you actually can just use this same technique with a standard single series bar chart and those indicator dots as well. The only problem is that with this technique, you can't put data labels onto these dots since these are just an extra series of data with that error bar marker. So that's just one thing that you might want to keep in mind. You're not going to be able to put a data label on top of this bar. You're just going to have to add that with a text box if you want it. I hope that you all like this video. If you're watching it, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and hit that bell next to it. Every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word, you'll get notified every time that drops. I had a great time making this for you. Thanks again, James, for the question, and I can't wait to see you all next time.